3 into d minus 2 y equal to 0. Okay, so we are having the first case, real and unequal roots. We are having the first case, real and unequal roots for continuous time system, natural response calculation based on the roots, how we can write the homogeneous solution or natural response. Okay, the general format before finding the constant values. Now, case 1, real and unequal roots, we are assuming the roots as m1 and m2. Now, this is our given question. We are trying to find out the roots. We are trying to find out the roots. So, d minus 2 into d minus 3, y equal to 0. So, d value equal to 2, 3. These are the values m1 and m2. These are the values m1 and m2. So, now how we can write the natural response is, natural response is nothing but c1 e power 2t plus c2 e power 3t. Okay, this becomes natural equation. This is 1a. Then we will use the initial conditions given in the question to find the values of c1 and c2. Substitute those values here, then the final natural response will come. Final natural response will come. Homogeneous solution, natural response, or free response, one and the same. Okay, so this is another question. Here also we will try to find, this is 6 into 2. We will try to find the roots. 6 into 2 is 12. So 6d plus 2d plus 12 into y equal to 0. And if you check here, d into d plus 6 plus 2 into d plus 6 into y equal to 0. D plus 2 into d plus 6 y equal to 0. D value is minus 2 comma minus 6. These are the values m1 m2. These are the values m1 m2. So how you will write the natural response or free response is c1 e power minus 2t, c2 e power minus 6t. This is equation 1a. Now substitute the initial conditions given in the question to find c1 c2 values and put those c1 c2 values here. That will be the final natural response. This is case 1 when roots are real and unequal. Now coming to case 2 when roots are real and equal. When roots are real and equal, let the roots are m1, m2. Okay, so be some values. For example, they are equal. Okay, are equal. For example, they are 2, 2, 5, 5, or minus 3, minus 3, like that. They are real values. There is no complex. Okay, I term is not there, only real parameters, but they are equal values. We will try out here. This is the second order derivative. D square means, okay, so d square means, what is the meaning? D square by dt square. Okay, if you put y here, d square y means it is d square by dt square for the y function. Output function is y. Okay, and similarly, this is equal to y double dash. Y double dash also same meaning. Y double dash also same meaning. Okay, output parameter is y. So now here you can write this as d square minus 4t plus 4 into y equal to 0. And if you calculate the values, roots for y, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Okay, it will become 4 plus or minus 0 by 2. And we are having 2 as the values. Okay, here 2 roots will come because quadratic equation, 2 roots will come. And the roots are 2 plus 0, 2 minus 0. Okay, it is plus 2 plus 2. So the roots are, okay, y equal to 2 comma 2, or d value equal to, here what are the roots we are going to get? Okay, what are the roots we are going to get are 2 comma 2, okay? Now how to write, from this how to write the natural response? We have to take the natural response as c1 plus c2 t into e power 2t, into e power 2t, this is equation 1. Natural response for the given question. Equation 1, natural response for the given question. Okay. Now I am going to next problem. Next problem, if you see what are the roots here, d value. Okay, instead of y, if I take d, it will be good because in the previous slide I have used d. So d values, we are calculating the root. So minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. We are having 6 plus or minus 0 by 2. And it is 3 plus or minus 0 If you take the roots, 3 plus 0, 3 minus 0. So two roots are there and they are equal values. So d value is nothing but 3 comma 3. In this case, how to write the natural response? Same. It is c1 plus c2 into t into e power 3t. Into e power plus 3t because the roots are plus 3 comma plus 3. Okay, this is second case, roots are real and equal. If the roots are thirds, example, m1, m2, the roots are a plus root b, comma a minus root b. Okay, so if you see here, if you find the roots here, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, it becomes 4 plus or minus root 12 divided by 2, and here 4 plus or minus 2 root 3. Okay, 12 is 4 into 3. We have roots for 4. I am taking 2 outside, and here if you see, this becomes 2 plus or minus root 3. The roots are, okay, so 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3. These are the two roots, 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3. So these are called thirds. It is of the form a plus root b, a minus root b. And how to write the response in this case? Natural response is, real part is same. So you can take it e power 2t, real part is same. And the thirds part, plus root b, minus root b is there. So c1 cos h root 3t plus c2 sin h root 3t. Okay, this is the form when the roots are thirds. This is the natural response when roots are thirds. Now you have to substitute the initial conditions given in the question to find c1, c2 values. After getting c1, c2, put it here. Then that will be final homogeneous solution. Now, if the roots are complex, example, the roots are m1, m2, they are complex means a plus ib, comma a minus ib. Okay, the values are complete values. It is not root b. But it is imaginary. Earlier, root b is not imaginary. Complete values are there, but it is not considered as imaginary. It is a decimal point values. Root b means it is a decimal point values. Thirds. Okay, now here if you calculate the roots, the thing is, the given question is d square plus 0 into d plus 4, okay, into y equal to 0. So the second term is 0 here. If you calculate the roots, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac, okay, divided by 2a. If you see here, this is plus or minus root minus 16 divided by 2. Okay, so we already know root minus 1 is nothing but i or j, which is the imaginary thing. Okay, here what I can do, plus or minus 4 into root minus 1 divided by 2, and this is nothing but plus or minus 2 into square root minus 1. That square root minus 1 can be written as i. Square root minus 1 is written as I. Here A value is 0. Using this, okay, natural response, how to write the natural response? This is of the form A value 0, only B value is present. A value 0 means e power 0 into t, okay, which is 1. And then c1 cos 2t plus c2 sin 2t. This is natural response. You need not take the e power 0, that is optional. Just to say that a value is 0, I have written like this. Okay, last question. I am going with last question. D square minus 2d plus 2 into y equal to 0. If you find the roots for this, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, which is 2 plus or minus square root of minus 4 divided by 2. And here it will be 2 plus or minus 2 into root minus 1 divided by 2. And it is 1 plus or minus root minus 1. And it is 1 plus or minus i. This is of the form a plus or minus ib. Okay, a plus or minus ib. A value is 1, b value is 1. These are the roots. These are the roots. How to write the natural response from here? How to write the natural response from here? It is e power at. A value is 1, so I am writing 1 into t. And then c1 cos bt. B value is 1 again. Plus c2 sin bt. B value is 1 again. Okay, this is natural response equation 1. You have to substitute the initial conditions to find the c1, c2 values. After getting c1, c2, put it in equation 1. That will be the final natural response. Final natural response. Okay. So what we have discussed is different types of roots, how to find natural response in continuous time domain. In continuous time domain.